What's up, Merrillville? I'm your host, Ashley Thomas, and we have an exciting jam-packed show for you this week. We'll be seeing highlights from the senior faculty basketball game, the announcement of the Merrillville Idol winner, as well as many other exciting events that happen throughout the week. So let's get started. Cinco de Mayo is here, but the question is, do you actually know what Cinco de Mayo really is, or is even being celebrated? Luckily, Amy and Joey are here to enlighten us about the special holiday. Take a look.
Cinco de Mayo is not a Mexican Independence Day as many people have thought in the past. It is, however, a very important holiday which should be celebrated by Americans as well as Mexicans. Why, you ask? It's simple. Cinco de Mayo is a celebration of the courage of the Mexican people during the Battle of Batalla de Puebla on May 5, 1862. 4,500 Mexican soldiers defeated the combination of Mexican traders and the French army of 6,500 at Puebla, Mexico. The victory did not win the war, but it showed the courage and strength of the Mexican troops. The Batalla de Puebla became a symbol of Mexican unity and patriotism. So why should Americans celebrate this day as well? Just a few reasons include the fact that if it had not been for the victory, France would have aided the South in the American Civil War, and this would have had an impact on the war. Also, Chicanos celebrate this day in appreciation of cultural and historical significance. However, today this holiday is more of a celebration of Mexican culture, food, music, and beverages that are just unique to Mexico. So now that you know a little history on this unique holiday, let's find out just how much knowledge your classmates have on this subject.
What is the date of Cinco de Mayo?
I don't even know.
You don't know the date of Cinco de Mayo?
I have no clue.
Are you serious?
I swear to God.
Alright. What does Cinco de Mayo stand for?
The 5th of May.
I don't even know.
I have no clue once again. I seriously don't know.
Do you know what Cinco means?
One.
You're fired.
Five. Sorry, Miss Sanders.
What nationality celebrates Cinco de Mayo?
Mexican.
Mexicans.
United States.
And does New England have a Cinco de Mayo?
I don't think so.
No.
No? No.
Does it?
No, it doesn't.
It doesn't? It doesn't have a 5th of May
at all? Okay, it does.
All right.
Thanks, Joey. Now moving on to something I'm sure we're all fully informed of, our very own Merrillville Idol winner. It was a close contest, but your votes were counted, and the final winner was Miss Paige Patterson. Lauren Sachs has a recap of the event.
During the halftime of the senior faculty basketball game, the final three contestants of Merrillville Idol waited nervously to hear the outcome of the contest.
Oh man, I'm gonna go ahead and do what I do best, you know what I'm saying?
I'm pretty confident. If I have to sing, I'm gonna do well, so it's all good.
I'm pretty good since I'm starting the game also with the national anthem, so.
And who was the winner of Merrillville Idol? Paige was allowed to sing a song of her choice during the halftime of the game. There were over 1,500 votes throughout the entire school. 120 votes determined the first and second place winners of the final voting. Paige's mother and grandma were extremely happy with the outcome of the contest.
But I'm very, very excited, very happy for her. But I'm glad she accomplished it.
I thank God for this opportunity. She started singing when she was 3 years old, and I knew she could do it. I love you, Angel Pie.
Paige received $100 for winning. She was all smiles as she remembered her long journey in becoming Merrillville's idol.
There are times I find it hard to sleep at night.
Man, you have a beautiful voice. You really do. And when you let go, you're really on top of it. You sound great.
And you catch your fears aside, and you know you can't survive.
I mean, you have it. You have it. You need to go out there and act like you have it. I mean, you're good.
Stop in the name of love before you break my heart. Think it over. Travel the world and the seven seas. Everybody's looking for something.
Thanks, Lauren, and congratulations, Paige. Speaking of winners, many showed up to prove that they knew everything and anything there was to know about their prom dates. with only the three couples who came out on top with leading test scores were moving on to the next challenge. Only this time, it involves their physical ability instead. Ed and Joey have the results.
Last week, PNN started a new game show that gave couples a chance to win a free trip to prom. And all they had to do was fill out a few trivia questions about their date. Now, this is the type of contest that could make or break a relationship. And quite a few people signed up. Let's meet the contestants of I Know My Prom Date. Each couple was given a test about their date that they had to take separated from each other. And the highest score will move on to the next round. It was a very hard test. Most contestants found out the hard way.
Man, we did horrible. She was leaving stuff blank, and she don't know me at all, man. We just met right outside the library, to tell you the truth.
And the truly desperate resorted to cheating.
Look at his answers.
And then just like, take a picture of it. Just rewind.
Show me some of them Spanish dancers.
But out of all the couples that took the test, these three came out on top. Dwayne Brown and Rhonda Landrum with a 76% score, RJ Zambrano and Megan Oliver with a 75% score, and Jeff Beeson and Madeline Govert with a 75% score.
Well, good job, guys. And congratulations on making it to the next level. We'll see you next week on our finalist round. Signing off for PNN, I'm Joe Morales. Do you know your prom date?
Thanks, Joey. Congrats to the winning couples and good luck for the second challenge. You're going to need it. You never know what kind of difficult stunts Ski has in store. I know one thing's for sure. Mr. Jennings can handle difficult stunts. For those of you who didn't know, Mr. Jennings owns a Harley-Davidson. Phil and Katrina have the story.
He's more than just your average Joe. More than just an average assistant principal.
On the day I was born, the nurses all gathered round and they gazed in wide wonder at the joy they had found. The head nurse spoke.
He's John Jennings, Harley writer.
She could tell right away that I was bad to the bone.
Mr. Jennings, an assistant principal here at MHS, is a Harley rider. Though that doesn't mean much to some of you, it means a lot to him.
One of the things that I do and have is that it's such a fraternity, you know, Harley people, is that you take a look at them, you know, they all have beards, they wear the leather vests, they wear the leather hats, or they, you know, they wear the leather this, they wear, you know, they've had a bad rep. And it's a fraternity. I mean, I have people come to my office, they see my pictures, they see my memorabilia, they see my ring or my bracelet, and the first thing that they want to say is, you know, what are you riding? Or they'll see the coffee cups and they'll say, you know, what are you riding? Or I'm riding this. And right away, all the barriers are broken.
Mr. James and Katrina took off on their ride and tore all over Merrillville. Katrina got a chance to see what it's like to be a Harley rider. Being a Harley rider means something. They go to all ends of the earth for their bikes.
You know, if you have to think about the kind of money that you have to be able to own one, then you can't afford it. whatever that bike needs, it gets done. They know they're not going to call me for an estimate. It just gets fixed.
Mr. James is a true Harley rider. The next time you look over and see one, look twice. It might be Mr. Jennings. For PNN, I'm Phil Keane.
Thanks, Phil. Who knew a faculty member could be so cool? But not as awesome as this year's seniors. That's right. It looks like the seniors have done it once again with an upset over the faculty during this year's senior faculty basketball game. It was a close, exciting game for the students. Jay and Ellie got a closer look to catch what we might have missed. Take a look.
Hi, it's Phil Keane here, live at the senior faculty game for PNN. Anticipations are high, and both teams want to win. So who's going to pull it off? Let's go to some of the fans and find out. How do you feel about the seniors this game?
I think they're going to do good, and they're going to kick some butt.
Kyle, I think those old legs are going to get tired, and those young kids are going to come through.
So you hear from the principal himself, the students are going to pull this one off.
You can be the mom. Oh, because see the girl them broke out from the floor. From you don't want a workplace performer. From you don't want a man where can't turn you on. Girl, make I see you when them upon ya. Can't stand for the long, not eat no yam, no steam fish, no green banana. But down in Jamaica, we give it to your heart like a sauna.
We want to see what you guys feel about the game for today.
Great expectations. Seniors are totally winning this year, totally, all the way.
What's your score prediction for the game?
100-0.
I think students are going to kill them.
You can be the mom. Oh, oh. Pumper exposed and girl, you got it test out. But you know we're soft, cause girl, you're impressed out. And if it is out of me, if it is out, cause I got the remedy for making it test out.
I believe the term is you got swatted. How do you go there?
Yeah, I didn't think he could jump that high. You got me pretty good.
We need set speed if it is to my test out. Well, I'm on the way this time. Cool, I wanna be keeping you warm. I got the right temperature for shelter you from the storm. Hold on, girl, I got the right tactics to turn you on. And girl, I...
The faculty is losing, so what do they got to do to win this game?
They need to leave Dr. Lux and the entire game.
You know, it's been said that you often cheat in the game and then go towards the faculty side, but I haven't seen it. But so what do you guys say about that?
The only time I've ever cheated was to help the students.
Against AC, what happened?
I was going for the ball. His head just got in the way.
Yeah, it looked like you were going for his head and the ball got in the way.
Well, we didn't do any more than you guys did to us.
They're pulling for the faculty. So your favorite player is obviously Mr. Naki. Why?
Just because he's our teacher. We don't really like him, but we made a poster.
Yeah, same thing. He's going to get shook all over by Bruder and Brenda. I mean, that's all. That's it. He's going to get stuffed and everything.
Okay, it sounds to me like right now they're playing for the camera. They really are traitors. And now they're trying to sound good to the rest of the school. Even though you got some of your favorite students on the faculty on the student team.
But I'm a faculty, so I gotta go for the faculty.
I'm sorry to hear that, Ms. Sulich. You guys gotta be the worst cheerleaders I've ever seen in my life. Why is this crowd so dead right now?
Why is the crowd so dead? I don't know. We are trying to cheer and no one's coming to help us.
I haven't heard you say one thing the whole time.
I have said go seniors. Seniors rule.
She said it about that loud too, so that's why nobody heard her. And that's why the crowd's dead. Looks like the seniors pulled it off again.
Yes, we did. Come on. We did.
garbage. Damn, I hit the game winning shot. Yeah.
Daniel Baker pulling off the game winning shot.
The game winning shot. D-Bank, the great Hogan.
06, 06, 06. Oh my God. Oh my God. Get me out of here.
Thanks, guys, and congratulations, seniors, on keeping the winning streak alive. I hope the juniors have the same luck next year. Next, Jaleesa and Brian got the chance to take a closer look at the new play, Beheld and Grand, being put on by the drama department this week. I have a feeling this is going to be a good one. Check it out.
The spring play is called He Held Me Grand. What's interesting about this play that's different from other plays that we've done is this play was just written in the year 2001 and was first produced in 2002. So it is actually the newest play that anybody would see at Merrillville High School, probably ever. I saw the premiere production at the Indiana Repertory Theater in Indianapolis in 2002, and I was very impressed at what a unique play it was. It deals with 100 years in the life of an Indiana family. You go back historically through generations. You learn about all different kinds of things that happened right here in Indiana, including the rise of the KKK, including blacks and whites living next door to each other, including the Depression, World War I, World War II, the war in Vietnam, a lot of things that have shaped the lives not only of the family in the play, but also probably your own family, your parents, your grandparents as well.
Picked up the paper, it was more bad news. My heart's been broken, my people been used. Put on my coat in the pouring rain. I saw a movie, it just wasn't the same. Cause it was happy, oh, I was sad, and it made me miss you. Oh, so bad, cause.
So we hope you'll come May 4th, 5th, 6th at 7 p.m. in Reinhardt Auditorium, and then we have a Sunday matinee May 7th at 3 p.m. Tickets for students are only $5. Bring your grandparents, if they're over 65, it's only $5 for them too, and for your parents it would be $7. We look forward to seeing you at the play.
Thanks, Jaleesa. Make sure you all make it out to see the play and show your support. To end the show, we're going to show a short music video done by PNN's very own Cameron Jones and Ashley Nichols. Hope you enjoy it. For everyone here at PNN, I'm Ashley Thomas. Phil and Katrina have the story. I kind kind of messed up on that one. Yeah. I'm better hosting her.
No.
Okay.